This is Dr. William Clark. I'm the director of the Chemical Engineering Professional Master's Program at Purdue University, and I'd like to spend the next few minutes giving you an overview of our program. From a very high level, the purpose of our program is to take your undergraduate education, whether it's in chemical engineering or another discipline, take that education and supplement it with a graduate program that in the end is designed to prepare you for success, either as a technical manager in industry or to give you the ability to pursue an advanced degree program. The curriculum consists of both chemical engineering courses and business courses, and we'll discuss this in much greater detail later in the presentation. And I would like to emphasize at this point that graduates of our program derive substantial benefit from their connection to Purdue University, a top 10 public institution in the United States, along with being a graduate specifically of the Purdue University College of Engineering, which is also very highly ranked. So just to say a few words about the School of Chemical Engineering and Purdue University in general, both our undergraduate program and our PhD program are some of the largest in the country. We currently have about 600 undergraduate students in our program and currently have about 170 PhD students in our program. And as I mentioned on the previous slide, our College of Engineering, according to U.S. News and World Report, is very highly ranked, with the graduate program being ranked number 4 and the undergraduate programs, chemical engineering included, is ranked number 9 in the country. We also are a very popular choice for international students, particularly for those students who are interested in STEM disciplines. So this is an example of a plan of study that for a student who has an undergraduate degree in chemical engineering. So a typical student would start in August of 1 year and then complete the program in one calendar year. In other words, graduate the following August. So a typical plan of study would be 6 credits consisting of chemical engineering courses, and those courses would be either in the first semester, either a statistics course or a math course. Most students take the statistics course. And then in the second semester, a transport course. The next component of a typical curriculum would be the elective courses that comprise a student's concentration. And we'll talk a little bit more about that soon. But basically, there are 3 courses that comprise the concentration. This is an example of a student who has chosen a concentration in biochemical engineering, one of our 7 concentrations. And this would be a representative list of electives that a student could take who has chosen that particular concentration. And then another critical component of the curriculum, as I mentioned before, is the 3 management or business courses, which can include operations management, marketing, and a whole host of other courses that students can choose from. And then finally, most students conclude their tenure in the program with a 6-credit Capstone research project, which we'll discuss further. Now, if you have a undergraduate degree that's outside of chemical engineering, most students in this category will need to spend an extra semester so that they can take, so to speak, catch-up courses to put them on the same level as a student who has an undergraduate degree in chemical engineering. So basically, there are 11 credits that consist of 3 courses that basically comprise these so-called catch-up courses. So the first course that typically most students would take on campus would be just the basic material balance course. That's what we call Chemi 20500, or sometimes called Chemi 205. And then the other two so-called catch-up courses are a separations course and then a reaction engineering course. Otherwise, the curriculum is exactly the same as what we talked about for an undergraduate chemical engineering major. Now, again, a critical component of the program is the ability for a student to concentrate in a particular area within chemical engineering. And because of the size of our faculty, more than 30 faculty members who both teach and do research, we can offer a broad spectrum of these concentrations. And you can see on the slide what these concentrations consist of. I'm pleased to let you know that just this year, this past fall semester, we have incorporated data science as our seventh concentration, and that's proven to be very popular among our students, even in the short time that it's been offered. Now, as I suggested, the Capstone research projects are a very important element of our program. And what we try to do in this program, and most students for their Capstone research projects elect to do a so-called industry Capstone project, in which they work on an industry-defined project with a mentor in the industrial sector. And what we try to do in terms of the broad scope of industry Capstone research projects that we offer is to cover the spectrum of different sectors within chemical engineering. So these are the companies that participated in the Capstone research program in the summer of 2021. And as you can see, these companies essentially span the entire spectrum of typical chemical engineering sectors. So biochemical engineering, pharmaceutical engineering, chemical companies, oil and gas companies, energy companies, and so on. So, and we expect that essentially all of these companies will also, in addition to potentially more companies, will be participating in our 2022 industry Capstone program. I will mention further some comments about so-called P2SAC, which is the Purdue Process Safety and Assurance Center, and also LioHub. Again, I'll make a few more comments about those in just a minute here. In terms of how our program is really differentiated from other professional master's programs and other master's programs in general in chemical engineering, Purdue is the only public institution that offers a large-scale chemical engineering professional master's program. As I mentioned before, we have a very large faculty, and that essentially is what allows us to offer so many different concentrations in our program. The three required business or management courses that are part of our curriculum, we believe, provide substantial differentiation from several other chemical engineering master's programs that don't offer this, so to speak, business perspective. We believe our program is very time efficient. Chemical engineering undergraduates can complete the program in one calendar year, and that allows students to very efficiently then enter the industry workforce. And then finally, just to emphasize, the Capstone program is a very, very important element of our program. Our students always rank this aspect of our program very highly, and it's unique in the sense that it offers opportunities for our students to interact directly with industry colleagues, and with these industry colleagues acting as mentors for their project. We believe it's very important during the time that students spend in our program at Purdue that from the beginning to the end, there are many, many different types of opportunities that are available. So obviously, we want students to perform well academically, so we, by definition, create an environment that allows for academic excellence. But because this is a professional master's program, we go beyond just a very fostering academic environment and create other opportunities for career advancement. And that includes things like our professional development series, where speakers from the outside come in and provide a many different perspectives for students to build upon and learn from. All students are assigned a mentor that is part of the chemical engineering faculty, and that mentor is charged with overseeing a student's progress during that student's tenure in the program. And finally, more and more students are taking advantage of internships and co-ops even while they matriculate in our program. And that's becoming actually a very popular feature of the program for many students, particularly international students. Although our program is not primarily designed to prepare students for an additional graduate study program, we've been very successful in placing students in very strong PhD chemical engineering programs around the country. And if a student chooses that pathway, then he or she can elect to do a so-called academic capstone project rather than an industry capstone project. So an academic project would involve working with a faculty member in his or her laboratory during the capstone research period. And again, we've been very successful in helping students gain positions in PhD, chemical engineering PhD programs over the past several years. Now, we have a couple of centers of excellence within our department that offer very, very nice opportunities for the professional master's students. One is our Center of Excellence in Process Safety. I mentioned this before, the Purdue Process Safety Assurance Center, or what we call P2SAC. And many of the companies, the industrial companies that participate in our Capstone Research program and offer projects in the program, actually also are affiliated with P2SAC. So there's this nice confluence of the professional master's program, P2SAC, and the industrial companies that participate actually in both of these initiatives within our department. The other center of excellence within our department is focused on the unit operation of lyophilization. And this is a particularly good opportunity in the pharmaceutical engineering area. And specifically, this center of excellence represents great opportunities for postgraduate research positions for international students. And if you end up enrolling in our program, you'll gain an appreciation for the great opportunities that both of these centers of excellence offer for professional master's students. And then finally, several students in our program have actually then been hired full-time after graduation by companies that participate in our Capstone research program. So this very nice pipeline already exists in terms of full-time employment opportunities. Now, just to highlight a couple of our recent graduates, Ms. Watkar was a 2019 graduate. These are elements from her LinkedIn profile. She was hired initially out of our program by Nestle's, and then was more recently hired after gaining that experience by McKinsey as a consultant. Another recent graduate of our program, Mr. Maglio, actually was engaged in a Capstone research project that was jointly sponsored by Pfizer and Allergan. And actually, Mr. Maglio was able to translate that Capstone research experience into a full-time position with Pfizer, where he was hired when he graduated from our program, and in fact had the wonderful opportunity to work on the Pfizer COVID-19 vaccine immediately upon joining Pfizer. So with that brief overview of our program, I'd like to say thank you very much for joining me. And I'd like to also say that we would welcome any interest that you might have in the program. You can contact me directly at the email address shown on the slide here, or you can go to our website, and the link is also shown on the slide. So again, thank you very much. Good luck in making your decisions about what the future holds for you. And we certainly hope to see you next fall as a member of the 2022 professional master's class in chemical engineering at Purdue University.